like how many bombs you can smoke, and there's how much piss you can drink, and there's also, you know, how much gear you can take.
The New Zealand police release a map showing what drugs are present in wastewater testing around Aotearoa.
In most of the country, methamphetamine dominates, representing almost 100% of drugs found in northern Waikato. But down south, it's a different story. In 2020, MDMA represented 95% of drugs present in Dunedin's wastewater.
Do you want to tell me what MDMA culture looks like in Dunedin at the moment?
A lot of people take it a lot of occasions. Yeah, doesn't really...
Very casual now, I think. It's just everywhere.
People like give it to each other as birthday presents.
Wastewater testing shows MDMA use has gone up 40% in the last 3 years in the southern region. While experts told me this has only caused a small spike in short-term harm like dehydration or hypothermia, there are concerns people may be taking it too frequently, which has been associated with long-term impacts to memory, mood, and concentration. Anecdotally, it's said you should only take MDMA once every 3 months, but some people in Dunedin are using it multiple times a week. The rise in Dunedin's MDMA culture has gone hand in hand with the popularity of electronic music, particularly drum and bass. The Lake House is one of Dunedin's central D&B party flats. Several of its 15 tenants are prominent DJs in the city.
One anecdote that I heard, which kind of blew my mind, is people saying that people in the Castle Street area will do a line before going to, well, like an Indian BYO. Like,
yeah. One of my mates in first year dropped a cap before going to the rugby. So he's just sitting in the stands, like, blasted. It was pretty crack up. There's people going out on Castle Street, Flow or O-Week, and they're just like dropping a couple ekies on a Monday or Tuesday, gurning to fuck. It's stupid, you're like, it's embarrassing.
For people who don't know what gurning is, you want to explain?
It's like when you take too much pingers and then your jaw's like going crazy and shit.
Go on, do your best gurning.
What does the MDMA scene look like in Dunedin when it's like working right?
When it's working right? Yeah, it's not bad. I mean, you turn out to a party and like most people have huge dilated pupils and they're having a fun time, having a great time. And that's generally the case. There's party goers and there's sort of, I guess, the music scene. And then with the music scene, it seems a bit more controlled and there's a lot more education around it. But with party goers, there's this, especially in Dunedin, there's this sort of idea of like the ideal breather.
If someone's never heard the phrase breather, what does that mean?
So essentially it's like a spin-off from Brother. And so it's just,
it's like a real Dunedin thing now,
real,
right?
Dunedin,
so it's like Scarfies have graduated into breathers.
Yeah.
But do you reckon MDMA is like part of breather culture?
I think it is a lot of times. I mean, there's like how many bongs you can smoke, and there's how much piss you can drink, and there's also, you know, how much gear you can take. And I think it's where, like, unfortunately, a lot of like the horrible stuff can happen, like people falling off roofs and getting into horrible accidents and things like that.
What's your experience been with like MDMA and the drug scene in Dunedin?
Yeah, I've done it a wee bit. I've always had music friends, so I've known how to take it, how often to take it, you know, limit the negative side effects of getting out of your mind. But once I got actually more into the music side of things, the drugs kind of died off because I wanted to be alert, I wanted to understand the music, get to know people at gigs.
You see a few people that are like doing it every single week in quite a lot of things, but I feel like for the most part, most people I think that we've seen have been like just for the special occasions like festivals and stuff.
Well, half the time it's bottles.
Almost a quarter of MDMA samples tested last year by drug checking organisation Know Your Stuff were actually synthetic cathinones, commonly known as bath salts. While the effect of bath salts can be similar to MDMA, they're much more potent. This increases the chance of overdose when users don't know which substance they're taking. Jai Whelan is a PhD student at Otago Uni, researching MDMA culture in Aotearoa. He has interviewed hundreds of young people about their experiences.
So why do you think MDMA use has been expanding in Dunedin?
Well, for one thing, I think it's just more available in general. Yeah. But another thing, I think the popularity or the increase in popularity of electronic music is really driving a lot of MDMA use as well. I've heard a lot of stories of people that come to Dunedin, didn't know what drum and bass was, first heard it, thought they didn't like it, get into MDMA a bit, and then they start to enjoy it.
What does a night out in Dunedin look like with town full of MDMA.
It can be pretty hectic at times. You know, people have a lot more energy. They're staying up a lot later. Town's staying fuller for longer. Mm-hmm. You know, the majority of people are still being pretty reasonable and safe with their use. There's always going to be a few people that perhaps could do a little bit more to reduce harm, or perhaps just be a little bit more educated on the topic before they get into it.
MDMA works by flooding your body with serotonin, a chemical that regulates your mood. When a brain is full of serotonin, it often makes that person feel elated, energetic and happy, as well as heightened feelings of empathy and connectedness with others. For a moderate dose, these effects last between 2 and 4 hours. For many people, this is followed by a come down, a post-use crash where the person can feel depressed, tired and anxious for days after use. A theory for come downs is that MDMA depletes your serotonin levels and the come down is the period it takes to replenish. But using MDMA too often has been associated with negative long-term impacts on memory, concentration and mood.
So if it is becoming more mainstream, but the education's still so bad, like what are the impacts of that? Like what are young people doing that they wouldn't if they knew better?
Yeah, I think for the most part, people, you know, should just be drug checking more. They should be checking up with their substances. People aren't very aren't staying hydrated. Sometimes they drink a little bit too much water. Mm. And also just people not really knowing, you know, less can be more with MDMA. Right. They're just doing it too frequently and not letting their body rest and recuperate after some big nights out. There's a kind of rule that's floated around the internet for a good while now, which is, you know, it's at the absolute max recommended, if it was to be recommended, that 3 months is a good amount of time to wait.
So only once every 3 months?
Once every 3 months. However, people are going to do it more than that. Now, I've had people say, you know, oh, on a big week, we might do it multiple times that week. But then they're mindful that, you know, on that last day, it's barely working, if at all.
So what do you think's next? Do you think like Dunedin has hit like peak MDMA?
I don't know, I'd hate for us to end up like the UK where people are taking eckies at 14 and 15.
Yeah.
I hope that, you know, the uni and promoters can make more of a push to, you know, educate people. And then it's really, if you know all the facts, you can make your own decision and you know the consequences.